Dad, he's doing it again. Must this dog stare at me all the time?
I don't know. Eddie, must you? Apparently he must.
What is so fascinating about me? What is it? In your eyes, is my head a large piece of kibble? Am I some sort of canine enigma? Think about it. Get back to me.
Here we go, gents. Dinner's up. Can I give you a hand clearing off your papers?
No, you better let me. I need this in a particular order.
What is all this, anyway?
Oh, it's an old case of mine from the police force. The Weeping Lotus murder.
Dad, I can't believe you're still trotting this old thing out. He's been trying to solve this case for 20 years now.
Yeah, and I'm not stopping until I do solve it. You develop certain instincts when you're a cop. And my instinct tells me that this case can be cracked. There just must be one small thing I keep overlooking.
There is.
Who the murderer was.
It's nice you're still so dedicated.
It's a hobby. Some guys build a boat in the garage. I try to figure out why a maniac could kill a hooker and try to stuff her entire body into a bowling bag. It's relaxing.
Hello, Niles. Sorry I'm late, Fraser. Just as we were leaving, Maris had a run-in with a rude directory assistance operator, and it shattered her calm.
Niles, have you ever considered that maybe Maris is a bit high-strung? Maybe she should see someone?
She's seen everyone. Why do you think she was calling directory assistance?
Evening, Dr. Crane.
Hello, Daphne. So good to see you again. What an enchanting scent you're wearing.
Must be the ranch dressing. Won't Mrs. Crane be coming?
No, I'm afraid not. And please, no more of this Dr. and Mrs. Crane formality. To you, it's Niles and...
Maris.
Yes, Maris.
Glad you could join us, Niles.
Oh, I wouldn't have missed it.
Well, I guess the food's all ready. Why don't we just go ahead and start?
Well, enjoy.
Where are you going?
I thought I'd have mine in the kitchen.
Don't be ridiculous.
Yes, we can't have you eating by yourself in the kitchen. I'll join you. No.
We're all eating right here, like a family. End of discussion.
Well, isn't this nice? Feels just like home.
I'm famished.
Me too.
You boys still say a prayer before you eat?
Almost without exception. Yes,
we thank you, Lord, for the food we're about to eat. You have blessed our table with your bounty. And thank you, Lord, for bringing this family together. And we also thank you for the other gifts you've bestowed upon us. And may we always remember to share with those less fortunate.
Oh, will you stop staring?
I wasn't staring.
Amen.
So, Fraser, did you happen to read Derek Mann's column today? You were mentioned.
No, I missed it.
Well, just as well. It wasn't flattering.
Well, still, I'd like to have seen it anyway.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so?
If I may ask, who's Derek Mann?
He writes that Man About Town column for the Times. Boy, the things that guy comes out with. Sometimes he's really funny. What'd he say about you?
I hate Fraser Crane.
Oh, sorry.
That's it? I hate Fraser Crane?
That's it?
Ah, don't let it bother you.
Well, actually, it doesn't, Dad. I knew when I chose a career in the public eye that I'd be open to certain criticism. It's the price I paid for my celebrity. But thank you, Niles, for bringing me the paper. And thank you for highlighting it in yellow. Oh, who would like some wine?
Oh, I'll have some.
Daphne, the salad is exquisite.
Now, why would he say that?
Must be the carrots. He always did like them.
Not the salad, Derek Mann.
I mean, why would he write a thing like that? I've never done anything to him. I mean, this attack is totally unwarranted. I'm a healer, for God's sake.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Oh, well, Dad, I have every right to be upset about this. You know, and I will not enjoy my dinner until this is
where it belongs, in the trash.
There was an article in there I wanted to save.
On what?
Nothing.
Come on, I'm interested.
Oh, let's drop it.
Why can't you tell me?
All right. It was all about Margaret Thatcher's secret for growing prize-winning zinnias. Are you happy?
Not really.